Hey, and what is happening, guys? Yankee here. We're back for some more Let's Play Fallout 3. So right now, we're going to use that key that we got in the last part to open up this door right here. I don't know, maybe this is where Majora said the drugs would be, or the pharmaceutical supplies, because that's an optional quest after all, and we have to find it for the good of the research, I guess. We want to make it as complete as possible to help out those wasteland survivalists. And anyway, if we actually didn't find the key and wanted to open it up the other way, you could actually get a terminal right here, which is locked easy, and as you can tell right there in the top left, I cannot open it because my science skill is not high enough. But if you did, or if you were going to, then you'd get experience out of it. So, experience, no experience. Hardest way, easier way. I'll take the easy way, yeah. Let's hit the easy button right there, and we're in the pharmacy room. Nice. Alright. Let's see right here. We got a... Whoa! A mini nuke! Awesome! That'll go nicely with my fat gun I just got. Alright, let's see what's in there. Pharmacy supplies. Okay. Got two stim packs, purified water, a dirty water, a buff out, and a blood pack. Oh man, we got some tiger blood right here. That's definitely winning. Oh man. Let's get that mini nuke too, so we'll be by winning. Oh man, some frag grenades along with it. Oh my god. But I tell you, this part has been so freaking hard to record for some reason. I don't know why, because I tried to record the first couple times. I was like, dude, can't handle it. I don't know. But anyway, enough with the Charlie Sheen puns. Let's get on with the freaking show right here. Alright, got some ammo boxes. Hey, I didn't want to open you twice. You're not that special. What the hell? We got office employee ID. What does that mean? Maybe it'll let us open this thing? Hacking. Okay, this is our first time hacking a terminal? Really? Alright. Alright, so you get 4 attempts, basically, and you have to find the code that it is. And let's see, packs. Okay, 2 of 5 is correct. Basically, 2 of the letters in that word is correct, and you have to try to figure out what it is. Disc, that's 2 out of 5. Takes 3 out of 5. Aw, man, when you get to 1 attempt, just back out and you get a free start. If you were just to do all 4 attempts, you'd be locked out of the terminal forever, so it's definitely wise to just back out when you get to 1 left. Sides. Woods. I don't know. I tend not to really think about it and just pick random things. I'm typically good with that for some reason. I don't know why. Alright, it's nothing like that. Wow, I'm really sucking it up. I usually get lucky with these things. I don't know. Maybe if I should try right here. Steve? What? The password was Steve? Are you kidding me? Oh my god, that's hilarious. Oh man, what a twist. Alright, so let's run the maintenance system. The password was Steve. Oh my god.
Loading personality. Robco. R0.
Alright, so we got our own little robot right here. Nice. Rob the robot in the flesh. Oh, let's get that beer right there. Nuka-Cola. Oh god, it has an error. Don't shoot me. Don't tase me, bro. I think it's... Yeah, basically, he has a taser. It's kind of like a laser gun, but probably the same effectiveness. I don't know. But then a laser gun probably puts a hole through you while a taser only just zaps you. Oh, well. But anyway, let's just get rid of a few things that we just got. So we can just drop some loads right here. Oh, perfect. Just drink a beer, and there we go. Good as new. Beer solves everything. It's the best miracle drug out there. No, it doesn't, kids. Come on. Don't listen to me. Ooh, scrap metal. Definitely want to give that to our good old buddy, Waiter. I keep calling him Waiter still. It's Walter. Ah. I don't know. I keep calling him Waiter. I have no idea. Alright, so we're... Come on. We're over-encumbered again. Really? What can we get rid of? I don't want to get rid of that. It's worth so much. It's kind of a waste to get rid of it. You know what, let's just get rid of the security armor, why not? Let's part ways with it. It's been... I know it's been a long experience, but... Come on. Time to let go. Oh, what the? The robot actually getting in a fight? Dude! Don't get in a fight without my permission. He's actually dying, too! No! He's my robot! Die, you fiend! Nice, we kind of have like a little partner buddy right here. What the hell, man? This guy's resilient! He's relentless! Oh, wow, 30. Okay, that's probably why. Frag grenade? Why didn't you just use that? It probably could have blown up that freaking robot right there. Oh, what the?
No!
You bastard. He killed Rob. Or was it Steve? I don't know. Oh no. I'll have to give him a proper burial. But we'll save that for another time. I'll take care of them, Rob. Don't worry. Your death will not be in vain. They'll all pay, I tell you. They'll all pay. Aw, man, it's so depressing. They killed our robot buddy friend. That's it. Rambo time. Everyone's gonna die for that. How dare you kill him? Another one. Die! This is for Rob! Oh, we got some bathrooms right here. Okay, this is the gentleman. Ladies. Ladies and gentlemen, okay. It's usually men and women. I don't know why they would rephrase it like that. But then again, this game takes place in like the 50s, kinda. Or not, it takes place in like 2020-something. I have no idea. 2277, I think. Yeah, that's it. But basically what happened was that society never changed from 1955, and it became like a 50s society until like 2077. That's why everything's all in 50s stuff. So yeah, that's my little explanation on that. Oh, we might as well show this off. We actually have a radio that I've never really turned on until now. Let's just turn it on and see what happens.
Everybody, this is Three Dog, your friendly neighborhood disc jockey. What's a disc? Hell if I know, but I'm gonna keep talking.
Probably one of my favorite things about this game is Three Dog, the disc jockey that's talking right now on the Galaxy News Radio. That guy is awesome. I'll let you just listen to him right now. Behold his glory.
A tree? No, no, no. Not those shriveled black things. I'm talking real trees. Brown bark, green leaves, photosynthesis, all that good stuff. Now what if I, the all-powerful Three Dog, bow
out? Oh, man, he's awesome. But anyway, yeah, there's probably more people in here. God, Don't tap the gun like that. You're gonna break it. Well, then again, it's probably repairing it by doing that. All right, so let's just Oh wow, there's a lot of stuff over there. Holy crap. Is this all water or is that a milk bottle? Milk bottles hold nothing. How useless. Where's the guy I just killed? Oh, there he is. How'd he get over there? God, that guy launched.
This is Three Dog. Ow! And you're listening to Galaxy News Radio. We're Radio Free Wasteland.
Oh man, I'm sorry, that'll never get old. Three Dog's probably the best character in this game, in my opinion. Come on, how can you hate that guy? Guy's freaking awesome. But anyway, when he stops talking, they actually play 50s-styled music. How awesome is that? Because basically the story behind that is that when the nuke exploded, every CD got destroyed except the vinyls. And the only things to go up till vinyl was until the 50s, so that's why everything is in CD form, and that's why there's only 50s music, so there you go right there. Because somehow vinyl records can withstand radiation or something like that. I don't know. I just gave you guys a history lesson. But anyway, I think we're done with the Super-Duper Mart. Wow, that was fast. Okay, I was expecting it to be a little longer than that, but we got what we needed. Now we're going to get out because we completely fulfilled that little side quest for Maora. Or I don't know how to say it. Is it Maora? Mora? I don't know. Let's call him Miss M. How about that? That's kind of too formal. Ah, and this music's so, like, it's so opposite to the gameplay, too. That's what makes it kind of fun, because you're, like, you're battling all these people, and all you hear is this 50s-style music just going on in the background. It's pretty ironic, to say the least. But then again, they have some pretty nice tracks on here. So, I don't know. I'm just going to leave this radio on for a bit. If you guys don't want me to, I'll take it off by all means, but I don't know, I'll leave it on for now. It's kind of refreshing to hear. Besides hearing the environment, all the crickets making sounds. Alright, so let's just do fast travel to Megaton. Definitely be faster than walking there. And smarter. Tales of a Junktown Jerky Vendor. Yeah, we've gotten that a couple of times. Probably one of my favorite, like, magazines. Like, they always give the magazines creative titles, but that one's probably takes the cake right there. Oh, man. So I guess when we return back to Maora, she'll give us some money out of that, or another task to do. That's great. And basically, when time goes like past a couple of hours, you lose some of the items you put on. So yeah, I lost my beer right there. That's definitely Doc Church. Like, that definitely looks like him. I don't know. Or there's Lucas Sims. Oh, come on. I saved your life. You still don't like me? And I still need my explosives to get up to 25. Great. Huh, man. So let's just go back to Mayora, get a new task, tell her what happened, and hopefully sell all this crap I found to her. So, pretty much a triple win right there. Don't say it. I'm not going to say the word. Let's see. Let's go 4 hours, because for some reason she's only open from like 8 to... I think 8 to 6 o'clock at night. Yeah, she's not open at night. I don't know why. Well, I guess she's got to sleep too, you know. Kind of have a realistic spin on it. Oh, great. Something just wore off. Probably the beer we just had. Yeah, definitely. So I can barely move my right now, but luckily she's right there.
Junk. So, how's the scavenging been? Got the food medicine from that Super-Duper Mart?
Yes, I did. Oh, you can lie to her, really? Wow. I'm not gonna do that. That's kind of mean. Come on. Let's see. It wasn't easy, but I found the food and the medicine.
Really? You did? You did! Well, alright! Tell me all about it.
Well, there were some raiders there, and... they, aw, man. I got in a little fight. They were up to no good. They started making trouble in the neighborhood. I got in one little fight with my bomb. Oh, man, I'm not even gonna go there. Cut that out. Alright, so what are we gonna do here? The raiders were using the pharmacy as a place to store their best gear. Let's just go with the intelligence right there.
So you're saying that they acquired a well-protected stash? I wonder how many other places are hiding treasures behind monsters. Well, keep what you got. Just traded for a big food shipment myself. Here, take a bit, my treat. Tastes kind of great after a while. Oh, and take this. It's an old food sanitizer. Just carry it with you, and it should automatically make most food and drink more, better.
Oh, wow, that's awesome. Okay, so I guess every time we eat something, its rads go down, it's actually more effective. Cool. We'll actually see the instructions. Food and drink improve. Nice. So it's active. Let's finish up the chapter with that landmine research.
Landmines are one of the few dangers out there that you can profit from. Disarm one before it blows, and you can sell it for plenty of caps. I've heard stories about a ghost town that's just full of mines. Traders just call the place Mine.
Wow, real creative.
Sounds like the place for some field work. Get in there, get back, and tell me all about it. And could you bring back a mine for my studies?
Okay, this one doesn't sound dangerous at all. That seems kind of unhealthy. How will you make it worth my while?
What better reward for avoiding explosives than to pay you with explosives? Frag grenades, in this case. I got a pretty good haul of them recently.
That's not bad.
And if you bring me back something to study, maybe I can make some modifications for you. Nothing like tinkering with a live mine.
I'm sorry, but her accent just gets me.
Oh, don't worry. No one ever goes there because they say it's a ghost town. And since ghosts don't exist, you can just focus on the landmines. I hear there's a playground in the middle of town. Reach that point and come back, and I'm sure you'll have some stories to tell.
Alright, I guess we'll, have you thought about disarming the bomb?
Oh, I couldn't do that. It'd be a real blow to those nice folks in the church. Besides, it's not like that bomb ever hurt anyone. Live and let live, right?
Not really. Someone can die because of your negligence. How about that? Alright, so let's sell a bunch of crap back to her. And it's kind of funny how I made fun of her for her accent, yet people tell me I have an accent for some reason. I don't know. I guess it's since I'm from New York, I guess everyone gets this. They're from a certain area when you hear everyone else talk like you, so it's not really that you have an accent and you don't think you have an accent, but I don't know. Personally, I don't think I have an accent, but to you guys, I probably do, so what do I know? But anyway, let's sell a bunch of junk that we found to Mayora, definitely. Ooh, leather armor, nice. Let's buy that. And let's just dump a few things that we found. I never will use frag mines, they're just too, I don't know, I'm not really into mines, or explosives for that matter, but, and let's just buy all the aids she has. Yeah, let's get all her aids, that sounds very healthy. Let's give her the knife, let's give her the lead pipe, the Tire iron. Oh yeah, let's give her the raider armor. I definitely don't want to carry that anymore. God. Please, just take it all. I don't even care if I went over on that. Let's see, anything else you have? And I think that's all she had. Ooh, definitely need some ammo. Shotgun shells. We don't have a shotgun yet. When we do, that'll be awesome. Let's see, we got ashtrays. Why do we have ashtrays? Basketball, bone saw. Yeah, let's just take all this out. Yeah, I'm just gonna leave this all in, I don't know. Because, I don't know, you guys, I don't know, some people are intrigued by, like, how you can barter and stuff in this game, so it's pretty much for those people that want to know how to do this, so if you're watching me now, just take notes. And let's just get some ammo out of it, why not? 5mm rounds, let's take a missile, why not? Oh, I owe her money? God, okay, I guess I'll trade more crap. I didn't care I gave her the scrap metal right there. I don't feel like going back to Walter, to be honest. Oh, we have a lot of grenades. Holy crap. Let's get rid of all of them. Why not? Actually, no, wait. Let's take back one of those grenades. It might be useful. Let's go back to weapons. Frag grenades. Okay, I'll leave myself with 3. That's fair enough. And let's give her the laser pistol. I'm never going to use that. Hockey mask I'll never use. Well, there's a lot of stuff I can still give her. Crap. Let's give her the helmet. All the beer. I never drink all that stuff, and it's worth a lot, so might as well. Three of those. And there we go. I think that should be good. Now we have 1,041 caps. Nice. Awesome.
How are those hot?
How are those hot little potatoes? Are you coming on to me? I just want to talk to you because I wanted to see if you can repair anything. Let's see. You can repair that. That's awesome. Repair my machine gun. Repair this. Yeah, it's definitely nice to have her repair a bunch of your stuff. Oh God, the fat man can get repaired. But look at that price tag. I'm gonna hold on that. Hold off on that for quite a bit, or just a little bit longer, until our money gets a bit much higher. Let's see, and let's see. We'll keep the armored on. Why not? What the? Don't. It's like in Pineapple Express. Don't. Oh man, but I think I've stalled long enough. That was kind of a long, little tedious process of bartering back there. But I think with that, what the midget? Gary Coleman! They do exist!
Yeah?
What are you doing? Oh, he's Harden Sims. Oh man, I thought Gary Coleman lived on. Oh well. See you later. I guess he's going out to the pearly gates right now. Just going up the spiral staircase right there. Oh man, but anyway, I think we'll have to end it here. Thank you guys for watching. Next time, we will make our way to Minefield. Yes, no Minecraft for us. Minefield. So see you later, guys, and until next time.